Hello, everybody. I just want to make a very quick video on Enphase Q1 and their earnings. I'm very busy today. I haven't had a chance to listen to the conference call. There will be another video coming with my full analysis of the Q1, but these are just my first impressions. So, Q1 2021 to Q1 2022, we can see that Enphase grew 6.77%. It's worth mentioning that typically around the turn of the year, that period from Q4 to Q1 typically is fairly slow for Enphase. When I went back and look at all the quarters, it's fairly slow. But nonetheless, it was much slower this quarter because the revenue quarter over quarter from Q4 2022 to Q1 2023 only went up 0.01%, i.e. it's flat. It is flat. They've still achieved the upper range of their guidance because actually they had guided last quarter that they would do this quarter. So in Q1, they had guided that they would do between 700 million and 740 million. And they actually did 726 million. So they achieved the upper end of the guidance that they gave in Q4. And I'm disappointed. I don't think it's very good. I thought they would beat it. I really thought they would beat that. So anyways, they gave new guidance for Q2, right? For the next 3 months. The new guidance for Q2 for the next 3 months is between 700 and 750 million. And so taking, again, the upper middle range, which is they achieved their prior guidance, that would mean that revenue in Q2 would be 730 million. Again, a teeny tiny growth, but essentially flat. So what I can say is that revenue growth is really marking a slowdown. There's really a major slowdown. I mean, it's becoming flat. That's a problem. That's definitely a problem. When I look at the quarterly numbers, this is Q1 right here that I'm highlighting right here. This is Q1, and Q2 you see that would be flat. Now it would be roughly flat between Q4 2022, Q1 2023. Q2 2023, we would have a roughly flat revenue line. So it's flatlining, and we need to be careful. Like I know most people, of course, look year over year, and the numbers look very good year over year. But I much prefer to look quarter over quarter because all of a sudden that good comp is going to disappear as you go through a quarter. So I realize there's seasonality, obviously, but when you compare seasonality to seasonality, period to period, you realize that nonetheless there is a slowdown, and sometimes looking at year over year numbers sometimes can hide the slowdown. I think it's fair to acknowledge that Enphase is going through such a slowdown right now. So it's disappointing. That slowdown is disappointing, but it is similar to what Tesla is going through with their product. And you know, I'll go ahead and say that, yes, these products are still today, I mean, very, very usually financed, right? Because a lot of installers are still charging quite a bit, probably more than they should, and financing costs have been going up. And so people think in terms of monthly payments, and of course they buy less solar right now, at least in the US where interest rates are so high. They buy less solar because they're like, oh, I can't afford it. The monthly payment is too high now. Look at my electric bill. It's much higher than my electric bill. And therefore, they are slowing down solar. And so one catalyst when you think about interest rates is that with, for example, the banking crisis that is emerging again, right, interest rates drop. The CME Fed Watch tool the drop has moved up by a full month, and they're predicting now that drop will happen maybe sometimes in October. Right, the odds of a 25 basis point hike went down. They're at 70% now, and we'll see today. Tomorrow, we'll see how much more down it will go, depending on how this Federal Republic Bank situation develops. So this is a matter of interest rates, and I believe as soon as interest rates will go down, the product sales will go back up for Enphase as well as Tesla. Interest rates are like gravity; they hurt every single company, country, household. They are like gravity, and gravity is very strong right now. And tax credits, right? Tax credits are still a catalyst, and this is something that I'll be listening more on the call to kind of see where to place the tax credit for the microinverters, that subsidy that Enphase is getting, you know, when that's actually kicking in, when that's being recognized, how are the factory rollouts in the US going, you know, are they rolling it out fast? This is all things that you need to look at in the conference call. But so like I said, the stock is revenue growth is essentially flat right now. It's not a catastrophe, right? It'd be way worse if it was going down. It's not a catastrophe. It is flat as the economy goes through a recession. In a way, I could argue that's still fine. But obviously, for the channel, I look for very high revenue growth. And right now, a lot of companies are going through that issue. And so the question is, how low will the stock go for the guidance miss? Because by the way, they beat earnings, they beat revenue, but the guidance was disappointing, which is why the stock went down. So how low will the stock go? Well, per this morning, the stock is down 23%. And at first glance to me, this seems like an overreaction. I mean, that's a first glance impression here. This seems like an overreaction. It often happens like that, but I mean, really, they're not guiding lower. They're guiding flat, and so, you know, and this company, you know, keep in mind, I do my most undervalued spreadsheet video on Fridays, and this company is I know a lot of people call it undervalued. A lot of people call all of the stocks that I follow on the channel overvalued, but per the stocks I follow on the channel, this company is actually middle ground in terms of valuation. It is not overvalued. Like this is not Shopify. This is not Nvidia, right? So anyways, it seems like an overreaction to me, because as a reminder, when you go back to the fundamental analysis, Enphase is a quasi-monopoly on microinverters, right? That's a major, major moat. They are quasi-monopoly. And also, they have an enormous network of installers. If you talk to any installer probably in your region, I mean, it's very likely that they carry Enphase. I've done the test in my area, and they all recommend Enphase. So they probably have an enormous network of installers. Many installers only carry Enphase, by the way, only. And microinverters, you know, if you invest in this stock, qualitative analysis, fundamental analysis of a product needs to play a bigger role. And you need to believe, if you invest in this stock, you need to believe, like I do, that microinverters are a superior type of inverter in solar. And you know, you still have older videos for a major part on YouTube that are arguing, oh, microinverters are not exactly the same thing. But when you dig deeper into all of the benefits, to me, it's pretty clear that microinverters are the future. You know, they are much easier to manufacture. Each solar panel works like its own solar system or mini solar unit. They last about twice as long that microinverters. You know, they don't have the issue of having to add optimizers to comply with city code, because if you have a string inverter, you have to add an optimizer near the panel to comply with the code in case there is a fire. You don't need to do that with Enphase, because the shutoff is at the panel. It has a lot of fundamental benefits, and I spent a lot of videos covering that in the channel. And there is the IRA bill, which will greatly boost the demand for Enphase. And I think it's also important to note that there may be a trade-off also in customers. It's like, you may be thinking about getting an electric car, and you may be thinking about getting solar on your roof. And maybe right now, with oil prices going up, maybe right now people prefer to get an electric car. There's a lot of things that go into it. Over the long run, I am holding my Enphase, and I'm not touching it at all. And over the long run, I love Enphase. This year, you know, who knows? But I'll finish with this. I'll conclude with this this final thought, positive thought. Is the company on its way to becoming a value stock? I know that sounds a little crazy, but, you know, when you see a day at minus 23%, that's a major down day. Another down day like that, I don't think that's going to happen, but you could make that case if that keeps going, this trend. The market dismisses any potential revenue that is like 2 years out or 1 year out. The market entirely dismisses. That's why there are so many opportunities. But current run rate on free cash flow which, as you know, free cash flow to me is the true measure of earnings power. It is not earnings. Earnings themselves, GAAP earnings, are for paying taxes. Anyways, the free cash flow is $224 million this quarter. Over the full year, almost $900 million over the full year as a run rate. If you put it as a run rate, enterprise value as of today, I recalculated back of a napkin really quickly. Right now, enterprise value is $22.8 billion. That would be an enterprise value of a free cash flow of $25. Which is, it's definitely not the least undervalued stock, but the valuation is in my view becoming pretty inexpensive. In my view, that's just my view. It's not expensive for a company with this potential, and I think, you know, the fact that right now it's that price is because, yeah, the growth is probably a few quarters away, and Wall Street is all about next quarter. It is next quarter for Wall Street and nothing else. So what are the next steps for me? Because this is a first impression video. I'm doing nothing until I listen to the full call. This is an important stock for me. I need to listen to the full call. So I will be doing that as soon as I have time. And then I'll provide my full opinion. I'll try to be as unbiased as I can after having listened to a full call. But my first impression is that this is an overreaction. This is a first impression. I'm not buying this stock until I've listened to the full call. So thank you so much for watching. This is not investment advice. This is just entertainment. Appreciate your likes, appreciate your subscribes, and have a wonderful day.